just 4 days after Yom Kippur comes the festival of Sukkot. When we basically are very much in the outside. It's a nature festival. A universal festival. It's 7 days of looking up and seeing the stars. Because the roof of the sukkah is supposed to be such that it protects us against rain, but we're able to see the stars. It's the festival of God's bounty and our gratitude to God for God's bounty. The four species that represent different fruits and vegetation. It's a nature festival. It's an outside festival. It's an every type of Jew festival, according to the rabbis, when they say that the four species represents the four types of Jews, and they speak about the spectrum between the etrog, the Jew who is filled with good deeds and meditation to God, and the Hoshana, the Jew who has neither good deeds or much Torah learning. It's a universal festival. Why does Sukkot come at the heels of Yom Kippur? Yom Kippur, I've just established my relationship with God. I've begun to turn towards him. Shouldn't the festival that comes after Yom Kippur help me turn even more deeply to God? Spend more time in Torah. It doesn't seem to make sense. The festival after Yom HaKippurim should be an inward festival, not an outward festival. We're just getting to know God. Let's get to know him better. In order to understand, I would like to remind you, or tell you for the first time, a beautiful thought I heard from Rav Shlomo Le Karlbach, a very beloved friend. He said very well, the conclusion of Yom Kippur is Ne'ilah. Ne'ilah is a closing door. Last week, I cited the verse, on this day, Kivayom Hazeh, the day of Yom HaKippurim, God says that he forgives us and purifies us from all of our sins, and before God we remain pure. So comes Ne'ilah on Yom HaKippurim. And this is the day when God forgives us. What we say to God is, please God, don't close the door without taking us in. Don't lock the gates without enabling us to come back to you. That's Ne'ilah. Rabbi Kaulbach said, and it made a tremendous impression on me, that's a little bit off, although it's conventional wisdom. It's not so much, don't lock me out of your world, God. But Ne'ila means, don't lock me completely in. The danger very often when someone finally recognizes God is that he forgets the other world, this world. He forgets other people who are not necessarily Torah scholars. He forgets the glories of the physical world that we're living in. Ne'ila, from one perspective, is don't lock me out. But at the same time, Ne'ila is saying, God, don't lock me in. Enable me to find you not only in the study hall, but in the forests, in the stars of the sky, in sunrise and sunset. Not only with my fellow Jew, who is religious like I'm becoming, but that sometimes I can learn great truths from Jews who are far removed from their Judaism. And certainly I must love them and learn from them and teach them as well. Certainly I cannot cut myself off from them. And the same goes for all the other nations and even religions of the world. That's Ne'ila. That's Ne'ila followed by Sukkot. Don't lock me out, but also don't lock me in. And therefore the world and every type of Jew knocks at the door and wants every Jew to be part of that great world and sanctify the world. That is Sukkot after Yom Kippur. Chag Sameach.